kick around how we got this all started, and it's a good story. Basically, we had developed our own fraternity over at this old boy's house named Clyde Hake. And he and I, he said, you know, we need to start our own fraternity, which we did. And we called it Alpha Chi Alpha, the beginning and the end and the beginning. Then we had to address the interfraternal council to try to get accepted and to bring us on campus. Everybody at that time were national. The KAs used to be the Paragons. The Lambda Chi's used to be the Artemas. So everybody was national fraternity. So we tried to get in as a local social fraternity, and they turned us down. Not once, but maybe two or three times. And there was a guy on that fraternity, I'll never forget his name, was Douglas Yates from Texarkana. But anyway, I told old Douglas, I said, let me tell you something. If y'all don't approve us on this next meeting, I'm going to whip everybody's ass in that interfraternal council. Lo and behold, we get accepted. And we go Alpha Chi Alpha and all the athletic events and all the everything and win them all. Archery included and whatever it was. We had a great fraternity. And we had about probably, 50, 60 guys. We were meeting on Monday nights just like the rest of the fraternities in an old building over an English building. And we wanted to get us a national charter with somebody. So I'll never forget, I'm up in front and I said, okay, who do we want to petition? SAE, so-and-so, so-and-so.
I think Joe Keelyhar is the one that said, my mama sure does like that song. Sweetheart of Sigma Chi. And Dudley Hess had pledged Sigma Chi at Texas and was influential in deciding to go Sigma Chi.
We started hearing rumors of what we were looking forward to in the way of a national affiliation. And I didn't know a lot about fraternities. Most of those names, Greek letters and things, I didn't know what they were. Most of us probably didn't at that time. But we had heard of Sigma Chi.
So I put it on the chalkboard, and we had about five or six names up there, and it was come time to vote, show of hands. Okay, all in favor. And so we, Sigma Chi, and that got the majority of the votes. So that's what we said we'd do. So the next day would have been a Tuesday. I picked up the phone, and I called Sigma Chi's in Elviston, Illinois. Never forget, I think the main man, he was an older fella, and he answered, and I told him, what we were trying to do. And he said, well, let me tell you what you need to do. He said, we need to send some people down there to see how y'all are and who you are and this, that, and the other. So they sent the TCU chapter over. And we shook hands and had fun. And then we said, why don't y'all come back? We'll have a little party. So we rent the armory in Greenville, had a big dance and girls and all that stuff, and shook hands with them, hugged their necks, and I guess they gave us a great recommendation because the old man called me. And he said, Lloyd, here's what I want you to do. He said, I want you to go on campus and I want you to find the best guys you can find and put them in Alpha Chi Alpha. And I said, without pledgeship? He said, no pledgeship, just put them in and get them going so we can come down there in whatever it was going to be, 4 or 5 months, and initiate you guys.
I came into the fraternity right after it had been decided that the charter wouldn't be granted. It was a long ordeal, a long process to get the charter. You had to go through several visitations by the national officers. The charter process was a long, drawn-out thing. It took us about 2 years.
Now, bear in mind, we didn't have anything but money that we had raised from beer bust and things like that, and we were charging, I think, if I'm not mistaken, $10 a month. Sigma Chi told me, he said, Lloyd, he said, y'all need $500. You mail that in with, your forms and everything. I said, $500? I said, that's like $5 million.
If we had enough money, we usually bought a keg instead of thinking about chartering a fraternity.
So we had beer bust and raised it, and everybody chipped in till we came up with the $500, and And Benny Longhacker said, well, I think we've got another 200 in the treasury. I said, get it out, because we got to have it. So we sent them a check for $500. Then in about, I guess it was 4 or 5 months, here comes the Sigma guys.
But we had had several things happen that week. You know, we were supposed to be silent and weren't supposed to have dates. And a couple of our brothers snuck off and got caught in the bushes with a girl, and we didn't know whether they were going to get initiated or not. But they did. But I think one of the interesting things that happened during initiation week was the fact that Kennedy was assassinated that week. Big dilemma. Do we put off the initiation? Do we wait? What do we do? And the national officer said, we're here to initiate these guys. And so they went ahead with initiation and granted us the charter then in November.
And they initiate everybody, and that's how it just about all got started. But it was a great trip. And of course, I made it a lot shorter than what it actually was. But that's what I remember, and that's what I, you know, think about when I think about Sigma Chi.
I'm still in Commerce, still have business, quite a few businesses in Commerce. And so the pledges I'm easy to find, you know, sign in the book. So here they come, each pledge class. And I enjoy explaining to them what Sigma Chi has meant to me over the last 50 years.
I mean, to me, it's a brotherhood that you know, you have guys that maybe you didn't have a brother growing up. Well, you got brothers now. And that's what it really means to me, because these guys are, they stood by me. And when I was in the Marine Corps, I got hurt, not in combat, but I got hurt. And these guys, I heard from them, you know. And so it was, it means a lot to me.
So that's one of the strongest bonds. I mean, right now, if I had any kind of problem or needed anything, I could pick a telephone up, call any one of my pledge brothers. And I'm sure that they would, at a drop of a hat, they would be right there. What do you need, and how can I help you? That is something I cannot say about other organizations and so forth that I've worked with and worked for and been a member of.
I know that I always had friends that I could count on, that when anything, it might be terrible, things going on, but I always had a friendship or people that I could turn to in any situation. And it is that way today, and it was that way when I was in college.
And how to live our lives and how to live by the principles that Sigma Chi had, to be honest and be trustworthy. And when we tell people something, we stick with it. We don't not do what we say we're going to do. And I think that's important in today's world, because it's easy to just say, well, I forgot or whatever. Well, you don't forget with a brother. You remember, and you make sure that you get the job done that you told them that you would get done.
Just had a lot of fun. Sigma Chi taught us how to have fun, but we had to make our grades too. And so I really owe Sigma Chi my college degree. If it hadn't been for that time, I probably would not have stayed at East Texas.
Guys, Sigma Chi is a lifelong experience. I can tell you that for sure. I was blessed to become a dentist later on, and one of the toughest, meanest instructors that I had in dental school was a guy named Dr. Leon Lewis. And everybody was afraid of Dr. Lewis, and he was really, really, really hard. And I don't know why, but one week I wore my Sigma Chi ring, and I got a call to say, Dr. Lewis wants to see you in his office. So I went to his office and went in, just scared to death, you know, and he sat down and he said, stand up. And I stood up and he went to shake my hand and he gave me the grip. And so he said, I just want to tell you, I saw your ring. From now on with you, You're not only my student, but you're my brother, and everything is going to be okay.
And wherever I go, and I meet another Sigma Chi, it's immediately a bond, and there's something that's special there. And although we might chat for just a moment, where is he from? It doesn't make any difference. UCLA, New York University, Missouri, Arizona State, University of Texas. There's a common bond, and it always will be.
I wanted to mention that my son is a Sigma Chi from the UTA campus, and he's graduated now. And one of the highlights of my life was when I was able to pin the white cross on my son. And there was actually a couple of tears in his eyes and a couple of tears in my eyes when I did it.
43 years ago, I was initiated, and I can honestly say it changed my life. I joined Sigma Chi, pledged Sigma Chi, because I wanted to play sports and meet good-looking girls. Both those things happened, but little did I realize the bonds of brotherhood that I would experience, and it's been everlasting. I can truly say that from my perspective, I'm a better man because I'm a Sigma Chi, and Sigma Chi experience is truly a lifelong experience.
Look deep, guys, because you won't find anything that has more quality, more resilience, and more alumni members that have lasted through the years and still love their chapter, love their fraternity.
And I learned about why Sigma Chi has the largest active alumni system of any fraternity in the world. I saw this in the Brothers of Zeta Eta. I saw it in the way everyone stayed in contact with each other. And if you fail to contact one of your brothers of this group, they'd be calling you and know if you're okay, if everything was going well.
Zeta Eta is special. It always will be special. The group of men that are Zeta Etas get together, do more, keep more in touch than any group of Sigma Chi's I know, and I know quite a few.
My only son is a Sigma Chi. So is my son-in-law. We're in business together. My biological brother is a Sigma Chi. My best friend is a Sig. So is his son, and so is his son-in-law. I'd like to see someone top that.
Greatest experience of my life. It was so great. I got my brother, who was working on his master's degree, to come to East Texas State, and he pledged, and it was rough on a guy his age, but he became a Sigma Chi. To anybody that's thinking about going Sigma Chi, and for you guys that have been Sigma Chi's and are Sigma Chi's, it's the greatest experience of my life.
It gives me the greatest joy to know that I am a Sigma Chi versus was a Sigma Chi, and I have the opportunity to see my fellow brothers in the 50th anniversary.
It's a thing that changed my life. I met a wonderful group of guys at East Texas State. But the thing that meant the most to me about them is that I got to see them grow into really quality men.
And don't ever forget that Sigma Chi is not just another fraternity. It is a lifetime experience.
But I would encourage everybody in each generation, I mean each 3 or 4, 5, 6 years, get together. I mean, don't wait as long as we did. I mean, we're in our 60s. I mean, we call ours the wrinkle butt or the Medicare crew. Don't wait that long, because it is so fun, and it keeps you together. So I'd just like to say that, I mean, Sigma Chi is a lifelong thing. I don't know of any other fraternities that actually do what we do.
Had rich friends that were not able to be with us tonight, and I miss them dearly. And I think about, gosh, we're having a 50th anniversary coming up, and I wish they could be there for us. There's a lot of us that are here for this reunion, and they're looking forward to November thinking, we're going to be, can you believe it? We're going to be Sigma Chi's for 50 years. That is a wow. And I'm proud to be a part of that. And I'm proud of my wonderful group of friends that I say are friends for life.
And I've been a Sigma Chi for 49 years and 5 months, and I have a long, long way to go.
Sigma Chi was the reason that I've gone this far. Without the brotherhood and the friendships that'll last forever, I would never made it. It changed my life. And I would suggest to any new members or pledges that they do everything they can to keep Sigma Chi in their heart forever.
You know, to really get close and understand it and help all the young guys out. Yeah, I'd highly recommend that.
For the good of Zeta Eta and Sigma Chi, you know, we're coming up on our 50th anniversary. And I think if anything I could say for the good of Zeta, it would be to the undergraduates that are there now and have recently graduated. If you will live your life according to the high ideals of the fraternity, you'll set a damn fine example for the rest of the world.